Thank you for granting this question, Mr. Speaker. Can the Secretary of State confirm to the House that paragraph 85 and 86 of the CEDAW report are not legally binding on the United Kingdom and do not constitute international obligations as confirmed in the explanatory notes of the 2021 regs, therefore undermining the whole premise for forcing a change in Northern Ireland's abortion law in 2019. Can the Secretary of State also confirm that according to the devolution settlement established by the Belfast Agreement, access to abortion services is a devolved issue, and this action represents a breach of the Belfast Agreement? Furthermore, can the Secretary of State confirm that his sole legal basis for intervention in this area is Section 9 of the Northern Ireland Executive Formation Act 2019? And during the passage of that bill, which was opposed by every Northern Ireland MP who took their seats, it was made clear that the only reason Parliament was interfering in this issue was because there was no sitting assembly at that time. Will the Secretary of State explain why he has chosen to take action in relation to his powers relating to abortion under Section 9 of that Act, but has failed to act on his duties in relation to the Executive's failure to introduce payments for victims under Section 10 of the same Act? I know that the Secretary of State shares my support for the Union, but does he not understand that at the heart of the devolution settlement must be a respect for those areas which have been determined to be for the devolved authorities? There is still time for the Secretary of State to think again before he takes action, which will undermine and further destabilise the devolved institutions. Mr. Speaker, it is time for the government to recognise the errors of their way and repeal Section 9 and restore Northern Ireland's life-affirming laws.